Welcome back to the channel. This is another Hillingdon race. I don't only race at Hillingdon, I promise. This week I'm racing at Abingdon, so it's going to make a nice change and a bit of a just a change for once, because I race here all the time. So Abingdon race, the Art Summer Series this week. But this is the E123 race at the Reading Crits that we did at Hillingdon on Saturday. And this was an absolute caning that I took. So I've just come out the Cat 4s. I've had one race in the Cat 3s. And the only race available to me was the E123 to represent Reading in. And straight away, I'm out in the wind. So my goal for this race was to simply maybe survive a lap. I'm not even joking. When these guys go past me in the other races that I've done, the Cat 3 race, they fly past me. So in my head, I was just thinking, if I can hold a lap or two, I will be really happy. And straight away, it's all single file, which I never really see in my races. And there's people out the saddle already. So I'm out in the wind, and I was thinking to myself, I really need to glue to a wheel today. And the goal was just pure efficiency. There's absolutely no way I'm leading the peloton. They're too fast. And today was all about just trying to draft, trying to last as long as I can. And I find that if you know you're definitely not going to be the fittest in this race, which I know I was, I definitely wasn't going to be the fittest. I had to depend on everything I've learned so far in terms of being efficient, getting aero, sticking myself behind people's near as many wheels as possible. So we're at 1:40 and it's finally bunched up, and bang, this guy goes, and I'm like, geez, we've only just started. I've only just like got into a bunch. But these bunches that you get in the E123 races, they don't last long at all. Straight away, first lap, going into the start finish, it strings out. This guy on my left, same bike as me, same wheels as well. So I thought, that's a fantastic wheel to hop on. So I get on behind him, and it is one long line, and we're going fast. And this is probably about as fast as I ever go down this, even on the finish laps in the Cat 4 races. It felt pretty brutal. So I stick on this guy's wheel, and that first lap was took it out of me a bit. But you know what? I made the first lap. That's part of my goal down. And the goal was to finish the next lap. I was just taking it lap by lap, trying to hold on where I could. And about a minute later, we come back round to this start-finish straight. Bang, people are out the saddles already going for it. And I'm hurting quite bad at this point, but I've made two laps. And it's so much faster than what I'm used to. Being a Cat 4, I've done one race in the Cat 3, and a gap has opened up within the second lap. And I'm not used to this pace at all. There is no chill with these guys. Thankfully, I managed to get back on this guy's wheel, and I'm taking it lap by lap at the moment. I just want to glue to as many wheels as I can whenever possible. If I can stick to people's wheels, I should in theory be able to stick with a little group. But it was hard. We come around into this corner here, bunches up a little bit, and I managed to get a bit of a breather again. And these breathers were few and far between. One of the things you may notice in this video today is I don't have the power, don't have the heart rate, I don't have the map or anything like that, which was super annoying because my Wahoo froze on me. So I had no stats for this race. So that was a bit gutting, to be honest. But 5:16, we're off again. We've just come off the hill. I'm in so much pain. And I really wanted to know at the end of the race, when I got home, to see what happened with my power numbers at the start of this race, because I so many watts, I basically electrocuted myself. I swear, I felt like I'd been in an electric chair at this point. This was way out of my comfort zone. Again, I'm trying to chase onto a wheel because that's the only hope I've got. So yeah. So a couple of minutes later, guy in front of me is having a drink. A couple of other people begin to take sips, and I'm thinking, oh, finally. There's a little bit of rest here. We're 7 or 8 minutes in. Maybe they were just trying to drop the only Cat 3 rider. Oh, there was two Cat 3 riders in this race. They're trying to drop us, and we've made the first 8 minutes. They don't know who I am, who the Cat 3 rider is. But obviously he's out the back. But hey, I'm in here hiding. Some other guy has gone off, here we go, he goes, but there's not as much reaction in the peloton this time. They let him go out, so I'm thinking, oh, we've finally chilled out a little bit. So we come around this corner to the start finish straight, and I was expecting everyone to start going like it's done on the previous 2-3 laps that I've done, maybe even 4 by now, I'm not sure. I've survived a lot longer than I had planned, and I think this guy here turns off to the left or the right. I end up a little bit out in the wind, a little bit of a gap opens up in a second, there we go, and I realise, oh great, I've got just full headwind, and then kaboom, this guy is going for Ken Buckley's land speed record. I'm like, what are you doing? Give it a break, we've only had 30 seconds, give me a minute. Everyone's out the saddle again, back to the house of hell for me. I'm on the highway to hell right now, and I'm like, right, find another wheel, just stick to a wheel, Michael. And literally about 10-20 seconds later, I start losing the wheel, and I'm like, oh no, here we go, I'm starting to break, and I could feel my legs just go into empty by the second. Moment I catch back up to number 28, everyone goes off again, and I didn't have any snap in my legs to keep with that and hold that wheel there. They swerve from right to left, trying to make it as hard as possible for anyone near them, and I catch on to them a bit again. Thankfully they're swerving, seem to slow people down a slight bit, and yeah, this was eye-opening. The moment we slow down, that guy is gone. He didn't want to hang about. Jeez, just watching this video back is making me sweat. About 2 minutes later, I've survived another lap, but the gaps are appearing in front of me. Luckily, this guy comes through to make that gap a bit shorter, and I managed to roll on. But yeah, at this point, it was a losing fight. Just staying on their wheels was, yeah, a load of power for me. I managed to get back on here, but yeah, I'm pretty much broken at this point. So as soon as I have caught on, gone on the left, nope, Cat 3's resting again, let's go. And it's just like, wow, seriously, bully me, keep bullying me. It's what I'm here for. I'm just here to turn up, represent the club, and I was happy that I survived this far, to be fair. This guy in front of me, number 16, I assume he's from the Pedalon shop, so yeah, he didn't quite snap past me as fast as the other guys did, so thankfully I managed to get onto his wheel, and yeah, we roll around these corners, and I think by far this is the most pain I've been in any bike race, and we're only 12 minutes in. It felt like I had done the last lap of a Cat 3, Cat 4 race over and over again by this point. And I was in so much pain. And about a minute later, this huge gap opens up on me. And I'm thinking, oh, this could be the end of the race here for me. I think I've been spat out the back. And I'm giving it everything I've got, because I thought to myself, oh, come on, just one more lap. Just sprint back on. So I'm absolutely trying my hardest here to catch back onto this group. Come around this corner. It bunches up a little bit again, as it's done in the previous few laps. And I decide I'm not going to just hang around at the back of this bunch. I'm going to try and go through them, get past as many of them as I can, so that I've got a head start for when they sprint. And there they go again. They're off. But my plan kind of worked that time, because I didn't get left behind at the back of this bunch. So rolled through, bit efficient, got onto this guy's wheel. And yeah, I survive another lap. We're about 3 minutes on into the race here, and this is something that kind of breaks me up. Come around this corner, and my indecisiveness costs me here big time. Guy on the left is going a little bit slower. The guy on the right has started to accelerate, whose wheel I was on, but I couldn't decide where I wanted to go. I wanted to go onto that guy's wheel because he was going faster, but I should have probably stuck to them guys who were back there on the left. And I'm open, out in the open, I'm hurting. I jump onto this guy's wheel, I'm like, no, I'm going faster. Go across to the right, to this guy's wheel. He's looking behind, he's probably had enough as well. I think we all have. I get onto his wheel, but he's going a bit slow. And I come round, this guy's on my right, he's trying to go to catch him. And that effort there really killed me off. Thankfully, I managed to stick onto this guy's wheel, but that was quite a decisive moment in the race for me, that because I couldn't decide where I wanted to be. I overtook this guy in front of me originally, and I'm back behind him. I should have just stayed there. He's elbowed me through. That was the elbow flick from hell. And I come around this corner, and I'm pulling people along here, but me, I've got no power to be gaining down on the on that group who've left me in front. Roll around this corner, and they're not to be seen now. And this is the bit where I start to, well, I'm dropped at this point. The field split, there's a few riders behind me. They've just gone around that corner up there, I'm not sure if you can see. Guy is shouting at me.
He's fucking 33!
Pull through, he's had enough of me. He goes, he looks at me, giving me the evils. Because I should have gone for it, but honestly, I was dying. And then that's kind of that. Hop on this guy's wheel. These two, I think his name is John, and the guy in front of me from Pedalon. This seemed to be a pace that I could handle, and I thought, I can't hang in with that faster group no more. So we got on each other's wheels, and we tried to catch up, come around by the clubhouse. It was quite nice because we had a few of the Reading Club members on the left. I think Chris was there, a couple of others, and then us three here, we just work trying to catch that group up in front. And yeah, it was painful. To cut a long story short, we don't make it. And yeah, so from here on out, us three here, it becomes a bit of a chain gang. We've let the race go. I think I am doing an effort here to try and catch up to that group in front, but in my head, I've kind of accepted defeat, because me on my own, I know I can't catch them, that little bunch there. So yeah, we end up doing a chain gang for the rest of the race, which was quite enjoyable. Normally on a Saturday mornings we do a chain gang at Reading Cycling Club. So I thought, right, that's my 18 minutes of pain done. I'm just going to roll around, get a good workout in, and just try and get a fluent ride in between the wheels with these two boys. And they were great, they were good company as well. But this race taught me a hell of a lot. So if you're unfit and you're not sure about how fit you are about starting racing, and you're Cat 4, or you're worried whether you're going to be fit enough or whatever, just do it. I entered this race knowing that I had no chance in hell, and for me, I knew I was going to get dropped within one or two laps. My idea was turn up, survive a lap, get the experience in of just riding with really fast people. But if you're not as fit as other people in these races, I would say your skill level probably goes up a little bit more, because you don't just need to power down, you don't have that advantage. So you have to learn how to draft behind people, you have to learn how to be aero just to stay with these people. So if you're Cat 4 and you think you're not fit enough to start racing or whatever, please, honestly, don't worry. There's such a vast array of fitness levels in Cat 4. And even if you are unfit, you're going to learn so much experience. And that experience is probably what helped me survive the first 18 minutes of this race. So if you ever have any questions or anything about starting racing, just reach out, comment below, and I'll try and encourage you and give you some advice, because I had a million questions before I started racing. This was a whole new experience to me, especially going with some really fast people. This was hell. Now, I entered this race, and fortunately enough, I became the Reading Road Club champion. So I was the only one from Reading doing this race, which was a shame. It would have been nice for a few other people to do it, but there was loads of volunteers taking part. There's a couple of people injured, a couple of people on holiday, and so on. So even though I entered this race on my own, at least, and I didn't really place anywhere, I managed to get that trophy, which hopefully I pick up at the end of the year, which should be awesome. So thanks to the club for that, and for the encouragement of cheering me on. And the other good thing about this race is I actually didn't come last. So that was a win as well. There was a couple of DNFs, but I'm not going to count them. However, there was one other person who finished this race, and they and I came ahead of them. So happy days, happy Michael. So this week I'm going to race at Abingdon. Give us a subscribe and like this video, because it's not all going to be at Hillingdon, I promise. And yeah, you'll get updated whenever I do these videos. If you have any questions, like I said, just comment below. I'd love to help encourage other people to take part in these races. Sorry there was no power today. I was sorry for myself, because I think I've just sold my soul today. Because originally this was an A race, so I gave it my all. And I had no power data, no speed. But I reckon I probably set myself some personal records in that workout. Not that workout, this race, I should say. But the other good thing I really liked about this race, which I haven't done at Hillingdon, is we had chip timing, which was great. I love chip timing, because you can see where you come, you can see how far behind you were. And it turns out I actually got lapped four times. but it's all good, I'm happy. The champion. So yeah, all winners. Subscribe to the channel. I'll post up some new content, some new race footage. It's been getting good feedback. Let me know your thoughts on this race. I'm proud of myself here, because I lasted way longer than I thought I would. Today's a win. I think my goal, if I do this race again next year, E123 Reading Crits, will be to try and, I don't know, maybe last the whole race in a bunch, be a bit more competitive in this race. That's going to be my goal for the next year. Oh, and obviously to defend the championship, if any of the Reading riders take part, which I'm sure they will now. Anyway, take care, subscribe to the channel, give it a like, give it a comment if you enjoyed this video, and you've got any feedback. It's nice to analyse where I could improve and stuff like that, now I've got a GoPro on. Take care, guys, and I shall speak to you soon.